I'm Dr. Cindy Matsen. I'm a breast surgical oncologist at Huntsman Cancer Institute. So this new study is just looking at a new way of interpreting a test that we've been using for a long time. The test is called an Oncotype DX test, and it's a test that's a genetic test on the tumor itself for breast cancer patients who have a particular type of breast cancer. We've been using this test for over a decade now, and it has been very important in helping us determine who needs chemotherapy and who doesn't need chemotherapy. What this particular study is looking at is how to reinterpret scores from that test to better understand who really needs it and who doesn't. So in the past, the way we've interpreted this test is there's been low scores, intermediate scores, and high scores. Low scores did not need chemotherapy. High scores did need chemotherapy. The intermediate scores, we weren't sure about. So when the test first started being used, most of the women with intermediate scores were getting chemotherapy. And so what this particular study was about was taking those women who had intermediate scores and randomizing them to either getting chemotherapy or not getting chemotherapy and then seeing how they did. And it turns out that depending on their age, the score could be interpreted different ways. So for women who are over 50 who have an intermediate score, they do not benefit from chemotherapy. For women who are under 50 who have a score greater than 16, which is a different cutoff than what we were using previously, those women do benefit from chemotherapy. So what this study does is it gives us a new way of interpreting the scores from the test, and it is based somewhat on a patient's age as well. Now this test only applies to women with a certain type of breast cancer. It's the type of breast cancer that uses estrogen to grow. It's called estrogen receptor positive breast cancer. And it's for breast cancer that has not spread to the lymph nodes. So that's the patient population that this test can be used in. And like I said, we've been using it for a long time. We've actually been using it for over a decade. And the majority of our patients that fall into that category of having estrogen receptor positive cancer that hasn't gone to the lymph nodes have already been getting this test. It just gives us a new way of interpreting the test, and it will lead to fewer women needing chemotherapy, which is a really good thing. They're estimating that it's going to save about 60,000 women per year from getting chemotherapy across the United States. So that's a large group of women. Within our institution, you know, it's probably going to be several hundred, but I don't know how many exactly. The majority of women with this type of breast cancer actually fall into the low risk category, and so they've already been spared chemotherapy. It's a question of how many women fall into this intermediate risk category and how many of them are over 50 and can be spared chemotherapy. And it is going to be a substantial number of women, but I'm not sure exactly how many. We've actually been really excited about this study for a long time and have been anxiously awaiting the results. Mm-hmm. It obviously takes a long time to get results from studies like this. It takes years for them to be able to see, to get the follow-up to be long enough to actually know what the differences are. And so this has been something that everyone's really been anticipating for a long time.